Hello, students. It's me again, Mr. Namaswa. Going to start from where we stopped in lesson 6. I hope you are keeping safe, sanitizing, washing your hands, and praying that things go back to normal. Now, this is our 7th lesson, and we are going to look at why and how accounts are used. Now, previously, we looked at the various accounts in business organizations. We looked at the income statements. We looked at the balance sheet. And we looked at other financial ratios, like the liquidity ratios. We looked at the current ratios, and so on. So today, our focus is to see how these accounts can be used to better our business. Now, we have various types of business organizations. The limited companies is our main focus for today. Now, how and why do we need accounts in business? So for limited companies, it is a requirement that they must publish their accounts for the public to see. Now, remember, limited companies, either private or public, these are companies that are accountable to the general public. In case an investor wants to join and be a shareholder, they must know how the limited company is performing before they can commit their finances. And so because of this, it is mandatory that they must publish their accounts, mostly in the daily newspapers. Now, why do they need to publish? They are used for ratio analysis. Now, all types of stakeholders will be interested in seeing these accounts to see how well the business is doing. And if you could remind ourselves, when you talk about stakeholders from year 9, there are various types of stakeholders in a business. I'm sure you can mention them. I'll just give you 3. Now, remember we said a stakeholder is any person who has a direct interest in how the business operates. For example, when you talk about a school, who are the stakeholders in a school? In other words, who are the people who are directly interested in how the school performs? We have parents, we have the owners of the school or the management, we have the workers, we have the government, and we have financial institutions, we have students. These are stakeholders. Now, in other businesses, we could have the community, okay? We have the banks who lend money to this business. So all these are stakeholders. So when accounts are published, stakeholders are going to see how they are going to be affected by the operations of the business. Now, we'll start with the first stakeholder, who is the manager. Why do the manager need accounts? Now, the accounts will help them keep an eye on the performance of the business. They'll be able to compare ratios with competitors and previous years so as to make decisions. Remember, managers are the supervisor. These are the people who are policy makers. They are the ones who are going to implement decisions of the company. So they need these accounts to compare how the business is performing with the previous years. They're also going to perform to look at the ratios of the company in comparison with the competitors for them to be able to make decisions. Shareholders and potential investors is another stakeholder, and we want to see how they are interested in the accounts. Now, they will see how profitable a business is using the ratios to see if it is worth investing in it. As a potential investor, a prospector's investor, this is someone who is likely to invest, and the current shareholders, these ratios will enable them to see how well the business is doing. So that those who want to reinvest, if the business is doing well, then they can reinvest more. To the banks, this is an external shareholder. And banks are very important because they are the ones that give finances or funding to these businesses. So why do they need these accounts or ratios? Now the banks want to see if the business is performing well to calculate the risk on whether to give out a loan or not. Now, there is no bank that is going to lend money to a business that is incurring losses every financial year. Banks must be assured the business will have the ability to repay the loan. So when they look at the accounts of the business, they look at those financial ratios, they are able to calculate the risk of defaulting in payment. So if the balance sheet is healthy, then the banks are going to give the finances. The other important stakeholder in the business is employees. These are the workers. Why do they need these accounts? Now, they want to see how safe the business and their jobs are. Now, like this time during the COVID period, so many disruptions have happened to the economy. Very many people have been laid off. Others have taken pay cuts. Others have gone on unpaid leave. So employees always want to see how safe and secure their jobs are. So for a business that is declaring profits, then the employees are assured of continuity. But businesses that keep on making losses, then it makes employees to be scared because they don't know if they have security for their jobs. Now, next we want to look at external influences on business activity. Now, these are things that are outside the business, what we call external business environment. These are things from outside and how they impact on the business. So we are going to start by looking at the government economic policies and objectives. Now, the first external influence on a business activity we are going to look at is inflation. And what is inflation? Now, inflation refers to the increase of average prices of goods and services. And this increase must be persistent and it must be significant. So when we have commodities that are consumed by most citizens and their prices keep on increasing for a given period of time, this is what we refer to as inflation. Now, the government wants three main economic objectives. What is the main objective of the government in regards to how the economy performs? One, the government wants low inflation. Now, low prices of goods and services will enable people buy more, and which injects more money in the economy. When there is more money circulating in the economy, what that means is that demand will be higher, which will spur production of goods and services. So more goods will be produced in the economy, which increases the gross domestic product, or what we call the GDP. So the government wants low inflation, or what we call deflation. Number two, the government wants low unemployment rates. Okay, the government wants to ensure that as many people as possible are in employment, whether formal or informal, whether employed or self-employment. Now, high percentages of people working so that they don't rely on government funds. Now, remember, the government has so many services to offer to its citizens. So they would wish that everyone else is working so that they can be able to afford their own lifestyle and do not rely on the government for funding. Now, next, the government wants economic growth. Now, growth of the GDP, that is gross domestic products of a country, means that more goods and services are being produced and sold. And remember, when we produce goods and services, one of the factors of production is labor. It means more people are going to be employed. The more people are employed, the less amount of money the government spends on helping them and the more revenue the government gets when these people pay their income tax. So these are the three economic objectives of the government. One, I've said low inflation rates, low unemployment rates, and economic growth. Now, let's look at something slightly different, and this is what we call balance of payment. Now, the government is also interested in having a favorable or a healthy balance of payment. Now, what is balance of payment? Now, balance of payment is the difference between imports and exports. Whenever a country exports commodities, that is called an export. And when we buy goods from outside the country, that is called an import. Now, remember, when you buy goods, we don't use our local currency. We buy goods in dollars. So, when there is a high demand for dollars, what will happen? The value of the Kenya shilling will drop, which is not a healthy thing for any government. So, any government encourages people to sell more and buy less from outside the country. So, if we are able to have more exports as compared to the imports, then we call this a favorable balance of payment. Now, an economy does not grow steadily. There are usually bumps where the economy does not grow at all. Okay, there are cases where the economy is growing, then there are bumps where the economy is stagnating, then there are phases or stages where the economy starts going down, what we call a recession. We shall look at them. Now, let's start by looking at a recession. And this is a